Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 24th of August. Heavy rain inundates low-lying areas in India's western Gujarat. Pakistani military establishment has sold Pakistan to China, says MQM leader Altaf Hussain. And at least 10 killed in separate bomb blast in Afghanistan. And now for all the details. Heavy rains lashed India's western Gujarat on Monday, leading to flooding in low-lying areas and swelling of water bodies. Levels of River Yamuna in national capital New Delhi also rose close to the warning level after water was released from the Hathini Kund barrage in neighbouring Haryana state following heavy rainfall.
Torrential rains pounded several areas in India's Gujarat state on Monday, causing waterlogging and disruption to normal life. Many districts including Surat, Gir Somnath, Ahmedabad, Gandhinagar and Surendranagar have been witnessing very heavy rainfall since Sunday morning. As rivers swelled and many lakes overflowed in the state, many dams were also reopened to release the excess water. 14 gates of the Motisar Dam in Gujarat's Rajkot district were opened on Monday, while Triveni Thanga Dam in Surendranagar district was also overflowing.
पूरा गुजरात स्टेट में जितना सीजनल रेनफॉल होना चाहिए उससे 18% एक्सेस हो चुका है गुजरात सीजनल रेनफॉल से 18% एक्सेस हो चुका है अभी रेनफॉल डेफिशिएंट होने कोई नहीं है लेकिन दो डिस्ट्रिक्ट में अभी भी डेफिशिएंट रेन है एंड अभी और एक लो प्रेशर बना है बे ऑफ बंगाल में उसका भी मोर इंटेंसिफाई होने का संभावना है
Meanwhile, water level of the Yamuna River, the longest tributary in India, has also risen and was recorded at 204.38 meters, close to the warning level at the old railway bridge in Delhi on Monday. The river level has increased after a large amount of water was discharged from Hathini Kund barrage in Haryana state as it reached above capacity after heavy rainfall. Annual rainfall is essential in India as rain support two-thirds of the 1.3 billion population living in rural areas who rely on farming. But excessive rainfalls cause problems like floods, landslide and waterborne diseases.
India crossed the 2.3 million COVID-19 recoveries mark and the case fatality rate has further dipped to 1.85%, informed India's Health Ministry on Monday. As the country's COVID-19 cases surged to over 3.1 million, the recovery rate now stands at 75.27%. India's COVID-19 recoveries have crossed 2.3 million and are more than three times the number of active cases of the infection in the country, while the case fatality rate, maintaining a steady downward trajectory, has further dropped to 1.85%, India's Health Ministry said on Monday. While India has been slowly opening up some industries with specific regulations, containment zones, area identified as most affected by the virus, still remain under lockdown. Earlier on Sunday, the government issued guidelines to open up its media production industry with norms for social distancing, crowd management and sanitization. Meanwhile, in the latest, phase 2 clinical trials of the vaccine being developed by Oxford University and AstraZeneca would begin this week. The trials are being conducted by India's Western Pune-based Serum Institute of India to manufacture and market this vaccine for low- and middle-income countries, including India. Moving on, Pakistan's Mutahida Qaumi Movement founder Altaf Hussain in his latest virtual address blamed that the Pakistani military establishment has sold Pakistan to China in the name of development projects. He also highlighted military operations against Sindhis, Mohajis and the Baloch people, which he said are part of the policy of the army to crush their struggle for freedom.
Pakistani military establishment has sold Pakistan to China. Mutahida Qaumi Movement or MQM founder Altaf Hussain recently said, while highlighting military operations against Sindhis, Muhajirs, Baloch and Pashtuns, which he said are part of the policy of the army to crush their struggle for freedom. Hussain in his latest virtual address said Gwadar and other parts of Balochistan have already been occupied by China in the name of so-called development projects, and similar policy is being adopted by Pakistani establishment in Sindh, where port city Karachi and other important locations are being handed over to China to usurp its resources.
So basically, Sindhi Muhajir Fasadat कराना एक साजिश है ताजा तरीन, और दूसरी मुकम्मल कब्जा चाइना का सिंध के वसाइल पर, मादनियात वसाइल में सब आ जाते हैं, बलोचिस्तान के सोने के जखायर, मादनियात के जखायर पे तो और गवादर पे तो चाइनीज का कब्जा हो चुका है.
Activists have long blamed Chinese projects for the displacement and killings of civilians who raised their voice against Pakistani military operations backed by China. They accuse abductions, torture and extrajudicial killings are used as tactics to muzzle dissenting voices in Balochistan and other areas under Pakistani occupation.
Moving on. Activist and journalist Tanveer Ahmed in Pakistan-administered Kashmir said he was mishandled and threatened to be killed by the security forces after he removed Pakistani flags in Dandiyal city of the occupied region. He was later arrested by security forces, and post his arrest, locals held a peaceful protest demanding his release.
Activist and journalist Tanveer Ahmed was last week arrested by the Pakistani agencies and security forces after he removed Pakistani flags in Dadiyal city of Pakistan-administered Kashmir. In a video, Tanveer claimed that he has removed a Pakistani flag from the area and said he is being followed by the secret agencies. He then climbed on a wall and removed the second Pakistani flag hoisted at the square. Reports suggest that he was later mishandled and threatened by the security agencies. Tanveer was on a hunger strike for a few days, demanding the administration to remove all Pakistani flags from the area. When the local administration failed to do so, he went on to remove the flags himself.
This was just one marla. This will be a big mahaz. Therefore, I have a request from all my friends that they think about these things.
Meanwhile, some locals in Dadiyal held a peaceful protest demanding the release of Tanveer Ahmed. People in the region for years have been highlighting police brutality on political activists and residents. They are resisting against Pakistan's illegal occupation and demanding Pakistani forces and other officials to leave the region.
In news from Afghanistan, at least 10 civilians were killed in two separate roadside bomb blasts in Afghanistan on Sunday. Several civilians were killed in eastern Ghazni province after their vehicle torched off a Taliban-planted roadside mine, provincial government spokesperson Wahidullah Zumazada said. In a similar incident, three laborers of a government-run gas factory were killed in the early hours of Sunday when their vehicle struck an IED in northern Juzestan province. This comes as the Afghan government and the Taliban are deadlocked over outstanding prisoner releases before the beginning of peace talks. Moving on to news from Bangladesh. Floods have killed at least 161 people in Bangladesh that is already grappling with the coronavirus outbreak. The flooding, which has affected almost one-third of the country, shows no sign of abating due to the continuous rain. Officials have warned the double whammy is pushing many to the brink.
Floods triggered by monsoon rains have affected nearly one-third of Bangladesh, forcing millions to flee their homes. Flood water that has ravaged the country, inundating houses and fields in the past 2 months, shows no sign of abating due to continuous rain. In Charkalpan, a village in Faridpur district, about 55 km from Dhaka, some people taking shelters elsewhere had returned home after news of water receding only to find that the water level was rising again following days of rainfall.
বন্যা আমরা অনেক কষ্টতে আছি এক মাস যাবতে বাজার ঘাট করতারি না এবং কি ই করতারি না খাওয়া দাওয়া করতারি না পড়া বাচ্চা কাছে অনেক লেখাপড়া করাইতারি না অনেক বাড়ি ঘর সেরে গেছে চলে গেছে আমরা অনেক যাবতে অনেক কষ্ট দিই বাড়ি ঘরে আর কি
Floods have killed at least 161 people in Bangladesh, according to local media reports. The country is already grappling with the coronavirus, with 294,598 confirmed cases and 3,941 deaths as of Monday. Officials have warned the double whammy is pushing many to the brink.
With Earth's resources dwindling rapidly, scientists are looking for a more sustainable way to conduct space exploration missions and to stay in outer space. In what could be a significant step in this direction, a team of Indian researchers has developed a sustainable process for making brick-like structures on the moon.
Researchers at IISc, the Indian Institute of Science in Bengaluru City, in collaboration with the country's space agency ISRO, have created space bricks, which have the potential to build structures on lunar surface in an affordable and eco-friendly manner. The researchers have developed a sustainable biological process with a combination of lunar soil simulant, bacteria and guar beans gum that can be used as load-bearing structures on the moon and other extraterrestrial surfaces. The cost of sending 1 pound of material to outer space is about $10,000.
Ours is a biological and a sustainable way of doing it. But we add a bacteria to this, to our cocktail. And then the third thing is we have to provide the right food and the right environment to the bacteria. And once you have done that, everything goes into a nice bioreactor and out comes in 10 days a brick. Then of course, there are finishing touches that we add.
India has developed a reputation for pioneering affordable satellite launches and space missions. Its unmanned Mars mission in 2014 cost just $74 million, even less than the budget of the Hollywood space blockbuster Gravity.
Varanasi, the temple town of India, has been adjudged as the cleanest among the cities situated on the banks of River Ganga. According to reports with 86.5 points, Varanasi has been awarded the title of the best Ganga town out of over 90 towns where the river flows.
India's temple town of Varanasi was declared as the cleanest city among the cities situated at the banks of Holy Ganges River in a survey. With 86.5 points, Varanasi was awarded the title of best Ganga town out of over 90 Ganga towns, said media reports. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi also congratulated the winners of an annual survey of cleanliness, Swachh Sarvekshan Survey 2020, launched as part of Modi's Clean India mission.
Safai bhi hai, aur ped paudha bhi lag raha hai. और इस समय तो बहुत अच्छा हो गया है।
The Swachh Bharat Abhiyan or Clean India Mission, which Modi launched, focuses on getting rid of open defecation and installing smart waste management systems for both solid and liquid waste.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.